Bonsoir à tous, attendons une petite seconde encore, en attendant pour que les autres puissent venir. Let's see who is here. So I hope you're doing fine. I am in a great mood today. Eka is here, Luciana, Maribé is here too. Ada, oh, Ada, thank you very much. Ada has been offering me a coffee. And you probably know that I drink maybe too much coffee, but then I love coffee. Yasmin is with us. Rita Assor too. Victoria Posse is here. Lisbeth, bonjour. Cosmina Bellutu. Let me check the others, because you've been starting to discuss with each other. Spiritual Weapon, sorry, is here. Hilary Howell, Bickert. Nam Gyal is with us too. Yossi, of course. Arpan Hadler, Widad, Tina, bonsoir, bonjour. Marcus is here too. Ashalu is here. And then Mohana, Sandra. Well, you are a lot. So, I hope you're doing... Ada is saying, jamais trop de café. But yeah, but if you don't sleep... This is the time when you're supposed to stop. Allez, let's start if you're okay. Okay, so as you might know, I mean, this week it will be at the same time, so we still have tomorrow for intermediate, and then on Saturday it will be for advanced. So tomorrow will still be in English, like today, and then on Saturday it will be for advanced, so it will be only in French. So be nice with me and like and share this video. It would be really, really great, and it means a lot for me. Allez, let's start if you want with the first exercise. And the first exercise, it's actually quite interesting, extremely useful, especially at this level. It's to express the possession with the verb être that will be used with the stressed pronouns or disjunctive pronouns, les pronoms toniques. Okay, so it should be quite easy. So we will use, of course, être, and after that we'll use these pronouns to express the possession. So let's start with the first one. And the first one, of course, how would you say it's mine with this structure? Remember, this structure with être. How could you write that? In French. Go for it. Alors voilà, the idea would be here to use the pronoun, so these, oui, les pronoms toniques qu'on peut utiliser, or then we call them disjunctive or stressed pronouns. Okay, so in that case, c'est, and after that we'll use the preposition à, and then we'll just put moi, remember, c'est à moi, technically you translate that with it's mine. So we'll continue, so it's a easy way to review again these pronouns and of course the structure c'est à moi. Allez, let's continue with the next one. It's yours. Let's go for the singular form, d'accord? It's yours. How could you say that? Alors, let's have a look at your things. I can see that Ashley is joining us. Bonjour, bonjour. And then Ice Cubes is coming too. So let's continue with this one. So it's yours. Let's agree that c'est à toi. D'accord? C'est à toi. Remember, we use the structure c'est. So once again, the verb être with the preposition à. And after that, you will put your pronoun. Pronom tonique, and in that case, it's toi for the second person of the singular. By the way, I've got a little gift for you, Ashley. Et voilà. Allez, let's continue with the next one. It's his. Alors, so third person, and then we're talking about the singular. Okay, so let's go now. Alors, we agree that if it's the masculine, then in that case, it will be lui, hein, c'est à lui, d'accord, let's continue, let's try to go a bit faster, maybe, it's her, so let's put now the feminine form, still third person of the singular. Voilà, as you remember, when it comes to this pronoun, in fact, you've got a difference, let's say that when it's the third person of the singular, in that case, masculine, it will be lui, when you compare it to the personal pronoun, so il is lui, but then funnily, when it's the feminine form, it will be exactly the same form, whether it's the subject, personal pronoun, so elle, and then for the tonic or the stressed pronoun, it will be elle. It's exactly the same, d'accord? Let's go for the plural, and you will see that the plural il would be exactly the same thing. So now it's yours. Could you give me it's yours? Alors, effectivement, c'est à vous, it's yours, and we're talking in that case about the plural form. We've been skipping the ours, but it's okay. Nous would be it's ours, hein? C'est à nous, I was too much in a rush, I guess. Now give me it's theirs, and we're talking about the masculine now, masculine plural. Thank you. Alors, in that situation, yes. Remember that the pronoun is e. We write it like that. Just let's take 1 second to do a bit of phonetics, if that's okay with you. Let's... Voilà, I will put the final X in red. We don't pronounce it at all. So this final letter won't be pronounced. And remember that when you combine E and U together, it will give you the sound U. It goes really, really, really down. U. C'est à E. C'est à E. D'accord? So in that situation, we agree that it's the masculine plural, d'accord? So let's give me now the feminine plural for the third person of the plural. Allez-y. Alors, oui, in that situation, it's quite simple if you look at it, because basically, it is elle, so like the subject, elle, remember, E-L-L-E-S, same thing here, final S, as most of the, in most of the cases, is not pronounced, okay, so in that situation, I will put it in black here, so you don't really pronounce it, d'accord, c'est à elle, so remember, c'est à moi, c'est à toi, c'est à lui, c'est à elle, c'est à nous, I skip this one, but still it does exist, c'est à vous, c'est à eux, c'est à elle, d'accord. Très bien, Veropol is joining us. Bonjour, bonjour, and I saw that Daria is here too, so, well, nice to have you. Allez, on va continuer with the next one. Allons-y. Alors, the next one will be extremely systematic, as we usually do, and the idea is to use the structure avec qui, so the preposition avec, and then qui, remember? So, how could you, well, basically translate this with whom in French? It's just to get warm, so it should be extremely simple, because I've been telling you that 1 second ago, just to get warm. Go for it, write it, please. Merci. Voilà, donc we agree, that's the concept, avec qui, allez. Now we will start to have some more structured things. So, with whom do you come? With whom do you come? You decide whether you go for the singular or the plural, do you? Personally, if I remember correctly, I've been putting the singular, but it's up to you. Alors, I'm looking at your things and, well, personally, as I told you, I've been going for the tu, but you can go for the vous if you want. So, whether avec qui viens-tu, we'll remember that in that case, viens, you will write it like that with this S, this form here, viens-tu, or then it could be if you prefer to have the plural form, so avec qui venez-vous. D'accord. Well, it's up to you. After that, you can go for the informal thing. So, avec qui tu viens? Hein? Well, then, tu viens avec qui? But, well, let's agree that if you really want to do it properly, the official and classical way would be whether this one, avec qui viens-tu? Or then, avec qui venez-vous? Allez, let's continue with the next one. And the next one is, with whom are you going to do it? With whom are you going to do it? How could you write that in French? Allez-y. Alors, I am looking at your sentences, so let's say that, well, this one would be probably the more classical one, the one I've been writing. So, avec qui, we agree, that's the idea of the exercise in that case, vas-tu, and then le faire. In most of the cases, this is what you've been writing. Alors, if you really want to put the est-ce que, in that case, it could be possible. Avec qui est-ce que tu vas le faire? It starts to be a bit long and a bit heavy, to my point of view, but it's up to you. Avec qui est-ce que tu vas le faire? Avec qui tu vas le faire? Sounds a bit informal. Avec qui vas-tu le faire? In that case, would be probably the, the most classical way to say it. Allez, let's have a look at the next one. The next one, with whom did you come? With whom did you come? I would like to have some past here. Merci. Alors, attention. Let's look at what you've been putting. So, Ashley was in the first place. Ashley wanted to go for the imparfait, and it's an option. Personally, I went for this passé composé, because I think that we're talking about an event, so probably it would be more suitable to put passé composé, but technically you go for imparfait, and it's totally okay. So if you go for the passé composé, and we stick to the tu, it will be more simple, if we all agree that it's tu, avec qui es-tu venu? Okay, after that we could say, avec qui tu es venu? More informal, because we keep the structure, subject and verb. If you want to go for est-ce que, avec qui est-ce que tu es venu? D'accord? Bon, Ashley wanted to go for imparfait. No, you don't need to cry, Ashley. Ashley, don't cry. Voilà, you don't need to cry. So, if you go for imparfait, monsieur, avec qui venais-tu? Or then, avec qui est-ce que tu venais? It would be possible. Don't worry about that. Allez, let's have a look at the next one. With whom did you go out? With whom did you go out? Allez-y, s'il vous plaît. Thank you. Alors, je regarde vos phrases. So, in that case, whether we stick to this passé composé, or then we can go with the imparfait if you want, because I can see that some of you have been putting the imparfait. So, it would be avec qui es-tu? Once again, let's put it nicely, you know, with the inversion. So first the être, and then after that tu, and then you finish with your past participle. Avec qui es-tu sorti? Less formal in that case. Avec qui tu es sorti? D'accord? If you really want to have the spoken one with the est-ce, avec qui est-ce que tu es sorti? If you want to go with the imparfait, no problem in that case. Avec qui sortais-tu? Or then, avec qui tu sortais? Or avec qui est-ce que tu sortais? Voilà. Alors, on y va. Lisbeth is asking difference entre sortir et partir. Oui, sortir, it's to go out. Technically, when you think about sortir, visualize a door. The door, I mean, you go out. Clearly, you go out, you exit a place. D'accord? Partir, it's to leave. In that case, partir, visualize the airport. The arrivals and the departures, les arrivées et les départs. So it's two ways of course, you express more or less the same concept, but still there are some differences. Voilà, voilà. Let's go for the next one. With whom were you coming? With whom were you coming? Allez-y. Alors, we agree that in that case, clearly, I am expecting. I could be somehow okay to negotiate before, between the imparfait and the passé composé, but here, it's clearly the imparfait that I'm expecting. So, avec qui venais-tu, d'accord? Avec qui tu venais, so more informal, or then even more spoken, avec qui est-ce que tu venais. Très bien, on continue avec celui-là, cette phrase-là, pardon. With whom do we want to travel? With whom do we want to travel? Alors, in that case, I was expecting the oui, I was expecting the nous, but I saw that at the beginning you started to give me some other persons. Well, we can start to negotiate if you want, but I was expecting the nous, let's agree on that. So, avec qui voulons-nous voyager? And so remember, it's also to show you that when you start to do this inversion concept, voulons-nous, remember that after that you will finish with the last verb that should be in the infinitive form, voyager. Avec qui voulons-nous voyager? Less formal, avec qui nous voulons voyager? Avec qui est-ce que nous voulons voyager? Are the other options. Let's look at the next one. With whom will you come? So we agree that in that case, I am definitely expecting the real future, s'il vous plaît, le futur simple. D'accord? It would be nice. Merci beaucoup. Allez, on y va. Thank you. Alors, je regarde, I'm looking at your answers, and I was expecting, this structure, avec qui viendra, so we agree that viendra, is the verb venir in the future. So let's be clear, and I will try to highlight here the stem. So look, le radical, the stem, the root, will be viendre. And so after that, you can see that your AS is in fact the ending for tu. Viendra. Now remember the way it will go. Je viendrai AI. Tu viendras AS. Il viendra A. Elle viendra A. Nous viendrons ONS. Vous viendrez EZ. Ils viendront ONT. Elles viendront ONT. Just to review the future simple. So in that situation, avec qui viendras-tu? Less formal, avec qui tu viendras? Avec qui est-ce que tu viendras? Are the other options, of course. But in that case, I was really expecting for this viendra at least. Merci beaucoup. Next one, with whom would you come? And in that case, I am expecting the conditionnel présent form. Allez-y, merci. Alors, in that situation, well, yes, I can see that you've been giving me the proper answers, so the proper form. So we agree that in that situation, when you construct, so it's the same verb, and basically it's the same root, the same stem. Remember that venir will become viendre. As you can see here, the endings are slightly different. So remember, when it comes to the conditionnel présent, it will be je viendrai, tu viendrai, il, elle viendrait. So A-I-S, A-I-S, A-I-T for il, elle. Nous viendrions, vous viendriez, il viendrait, elle viendrait, A-I-E-N-T. Voilà, merci beaucoup, et vous êtes des spécialistes maintenant, pour la structure avec qui. Alors, Yossi is asking, why do we need to use the hyphen? We use the hyphen when we do the inversion, Yossi. It's just to show that, in fact, this pronoun that you have after is connected to the verb and not to something that can come after. Because basically, you could consider that the next verb, if you've got an infinitive, you could consider that, in fact, this tu could be somehow linked to the verb that comes after. So no, when you have the hyphen, it's just to show that clearly this personal pronoun that normally should be before the verb, but that you put after the verb for this question, is still connected to this first verb. D'accord? Bon, j'espère que c'était clair. Somebody is trying to write some things. I will hide this person. Allez, let's continue with the next thing. I don't know, people want to write some strange things sometimes. Don't forget to like, it would be really, really nice. You know that my little pleasure is to have 100 likes per exercise. It's not much to ask. You are 115 right now. It would be possible. Just click on the like and I would be so, so happy. Merci beaucoup. So now we will work together with the expression avoir besoin de. Remember, we use it a lot. Hein? So in some cases, whether you want to say je veux or then j'ai besoin de quelque chose, it's to need. Hein? We agree that we can use it quite often. Let's try to be romantic. I need you. How could you say that in French with the expression avoir besoin de? Allez-y. Alors, Fizzle is asking an interesting question, and I think that probably Ashley could answer if Ashley is still here. I'm not really sure. Fizzle was asking, what's the name of the song? And I assume that Fizzle was talking about this one. So you should ask Ashley, because Ashley is the king and it's his song. In fact, it is his song since March when we started the thing. Allez, let's have a look. So, the answer was j'ai besoin de toi. So, avoir besoin de, so let's agree that you need to conjugate your verb avoir. So, you will put that in that case in the present, j'ai. After that, you put besoin, then remember to put your preposition de, and you finish with, in that case, well, once again, les pronoms toniques. So remember, moi, toi, lui, elle, nous, vous, eux, elle. Très bien. Allez, on continue avec, something different in that case. I need some coffee. I would like you to emphasize on the some. Hein? I need some coffee. Allez-y. Alors, let's have a look. And by the way, if you like NTM, which I did when I was young, I was so pleased to see that for the last season of this French series, Engrenage, so it's the last one, they won't do any more seasons after that, Joe Star is actually having a big, big part. He's acting in this series, and Joe Star is a good, good actor in his type of character, so he's really good. Huh? So Cool Shen and Joestar, these two persons who were belonging to this this group, are now actors and still singers, but they're more acting, I guess. J'ai besoin de café. Remember that in that case, when we'll go with the expression avoir besoin de, you won't start to put this du, and this is the tricky one. So that's the reason why I wanted you to see if you don't put j'ai besoin du café, but you will go for j'ai besoin de café. Be careful, it's a common mistake, so you need to stick your de, d'accord? J'ai besoin de café. And yes, Daria is totally right. Please click on this little thing. Look, hop, Eh oui, you just need to click, and one click can change my mood. You have no clue. You have no clue. After that, I'm a happy man. Merci beaucoup. I need to drink. So in that case, it will be interesting because now we start to combine that with a verb. So how could you use avoir besoin de and then a verb? Go for it. Alors, one more time, it's the same concept. You don't touch your preposition de, hein, we agree. J'ai besoin de, and then boire. So remember, j'ai besoin de, and then you can have some pronouns after that, like we had. J'ai besoin de toi, j'ai besoin de lui. Then you can have some nouns. J'ai besoin de café, j'ai besoin de banane. Or then we can have a verb. J'ai besoin de boire. So remember that you don't touch your de. Hein? And I don't know if it answers to the question. Somebody was asking whether it's du or de. No, 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 you don't touch it. Whether it's a verb, a pronoun, or then if it's a substantive after, sorry, it will come. That in that case, you don't change. So, why not? Well, that's what I explained. Samantha, I just explained that. So, I hope it's the delay because I just answered to your question. Allez, on continue. Alors, sorry, I was clicking a bit too fast. And in that case, it's I need to tell him. I need to tell him. So how would you translate that into French using the structure that we're working on? Avoir besoin de. Allez-y. Alors, Catégique is asking de un café, but it's another story in that case. Yes, if you definitely want to introduce this concept with the quantity. So, because if you say, I want some coffee, and this some, in that case, you will go for j'ai besoin de café. If you want to specify the fact that you need one, in that case, you keep the structure j'ai besoin de. After that, you will put your article, un, and obviously, a from your preposition will have to go away, and you will put your apostrophe. J'ai besoin d'un café. Yeah, but still, de is there. D'accord, that's the point. So in that situation, let's have a look at your sentences. It's exactly the same concept. J'ai besoin de. D'accord? Then we have the verb dire, but then the concept, as you know, is to put the pronoun here, complément d'objet indirect, before your infinitive. J'ai besoin de lui. Hein? Indirect in that case. Hein? De lui dire. D'accord? Allez, nous continuons avec la suivante. I need to see you. I need to see you. How would you translate that into French with the expression avoir besoin de? Alors effectivement, in that case, well, it's exactly the same type of structure, so we agree, and it's just to repeat, to see, so j'ai besoin de, then you will put your pronoun te, I mean, in that case, we agree that this pronoun is a complément d'objet direct, donc j'ai besoin de te, and then after that you finish with your infinitive, voir, j'ai besoin de te, be careful, Patricia, it's not tu voir, but it's te. Remember all the pronouns, me, te, le, la, nous, vous, les. J'ai besoin de me voir. It's a funny thing, but maybe. J'ai besoin de te voir, j'ai besoin de le voir, j'ai besoin de la voir. J'ai besoin de nous voir, j'ai besoin de vous voir, j'ai besoin de les voir, pluriel. D'accord? Allez, nous continuons avec la prochaine phrase. So let's continue with this one. I need to talk to them. I need to talk to them. Allez-y, s'il vous plaît. No, 138 persons are watching this this stream right now. 39, and I've got only 88 likes. It's not reasonable. Please click on the like. Be nice with me. This is my little pleasure. My little pleasure in exchange for this lesson for you. Merci beaucoup. Alors, we do agree that in that case, yes, it's exactly the same structure. Once again, j'ai besoin de. And after that, we will put, well, in that case, it must be indirect pronoun. So, sorry, pronom complément d'objet indirect, leur. It's the plural form. And then after that, you continue, of course, with your infinitive. J'ai besoin de leur. Parler, misto, j'ai besoin de parler avec eux. Yeah, but that's not the concept in that situation. The idea was to use the j'ai besoin de, and of course to use the pronoun, just to see how you structure that. It would be the proper way. The way you say it, j'ai besoin de parler avec eux, is totally okay, but it's not, let's say that it's not really structured like this sentence that I've been giving you. D'accord? Merci beaucoup. Allez, nous continuons. Alors, un grand merci, Rita. One more time, Rita is the official sponsor of my coffee here because each time, you know, you don't need it. I mean, I just want a like. I'm a happy man with a like. Allez, let's try to play with this ce qui structure. Ce qui structure would be interesting to see together. So we've been reaching the 100 likes. I don't know who said that, you know, you can die. Well, I guess I could. Let's go for this structure. What is interesting? How could you, structure that in French with the ce qui? The idea would be systematically to use ce qui. Remember that. Allez-y. Thank you. Alors, in that situation, yeah, look, we will structure it in a really, really clear way. So, ce qui, after that, you will put the verb. So, in that case, it's être, d'accord? So, être should be in the third person of the singular. So, ce qui est. And then, the adjective that you will put after will be automatically in the masculine form. D'accord? Ce qui est intéressant. Ce qui est intéressant. So remember to write intéressant, well, the way you can see on your screen. One R and deux S. Let's be generous with the S. This is the reason why you have this strong, strong s. Intéressant. D'accord? Allez, on continue. What is beautiful? What is beautiful? How do you say that in French? Alors, that's it. And we continue in the same logic. So remember, I told you ce qui, then the verb should be in the third person of the singular est. And remember, after that, the adjective should be in the masculine form ce qui est beau. D'accord? Ce qui est beau. The adjective should definitely always, but it seems that it's okay now. Sundar, remember. Sundar, adjective in the masculine form. Luciana, you don't have any two options. No. It will be always the masculine form. Ce qui est beau. D'accord? Allez, on continue. What is good? What is good? Same logic. Continue like that. Merci. Alors, oui, apparemment, everything is okay. Patricia, be careful, because Patricia was explaining the fact that each time in these structures, you should definitely always put your adjective in the masculine form. D'accord? Ce qui est bon. Ce qui est bon. Ashley, quoi de neuf? I don't know what. What do you want to ask, Mister? Huh? Qu'est-ce qui se passe, Monsieur? Alors, let's go for the next one. Now, look, we start to structure and to have some longer sentences. What interests me makes me passionate. What interests me makes me passionate. How could you structure this sentence? Go for it. Alors, in that situation, it's always interesting to see how to translate because we can have many options, I guess. I would personally go for the simple way, like with the verb. We have a verb and passion is a verb. So, I think it would be more simple to go for this structure. Ce qui m'intéresse me passionne. Alors après ça, well, let's look at some of you went to go passionné, rendre passionné. It's a bit too heavy because in most of the cases we will go for the verb if we have a verb and we can try to make it simple if it's possible, like some persons in the group like that. So ce qui m'intéresse me passion would be the best and most simple option. D'accord? Remember that in that case, the verb is passionné, first group, so definitely you should conjugate it in the third person of the singular. Ce qui m'intéresse me passionne. Regardez, what saddened me makes me weak. Attention, what saddened me makes me weak. Allez-y. Alors, I can see that it's a bit more tricky, apparently. I don't really know if. Alors, let me check. Here it's quite interesting. Apparently, you will discover some new things, and I'm really happy for you. There is a verb, and the verb it's attrister. Attrister. So in some cases, you wanted to go for faire triste. We don't use faire triste. We could use rendre triste would be an option, but same thing here. Rendre triste. It's a bit heavy. I mean, we have the verb. The verb is attrister. Attrister, in that case, it will be from the first group. So, ce qui m apostrophe attriste, ce qui attriste moi, hein, ce qui m'attriste me rend faible. We could even go for another verb that is affaiblir, but I didn't want to go too far. So, ce qui m'attriste me rend faible. Or then we could say, ce qui m'attriste m'affaiblit. Affaiblir, remember, it will be a verb from the second group. So, in that situation, maybe this one would be the most simple option. It's a bit tricky, the structure, and I know that it might be difficult. Spiritual Weapons is saying, trop difficile pour moi. Well, don't worry, Spiritual Weapons, only one more. D'accord? Only one more, and here it is. What doesn't interest me bothers me. What doesn't interest me bothers me. Try to make me a sentence with that. Merci beaucoup. Alors, Ashley says, I never saw the verb attrister. Well, it's my pleasure now. It's my pleasure, my little gift to you, Ashley. Voilà, monsieur, I'm offering you a new verb. You can use it like tu m'attristes. Or then, cette situation m'attriste. So, me rend triste. After that, you can brag about the fact that you know this beautiful verb. Okay, let's have a look at the sentence now. Ce qui ne me plaît pas m'ennuie. Alors, you went for m'intéresse, ouais. No problem about that, I could accept. Hein. Ce qui ne m'intéresse pas. Alors, bother, it's really ennuyer. Hein. Me dérange, Sundar went for déranger. Déranger, it's a bit more like to disturb, hein, disturbs me, but But we could accept it. If you really want to stick to the translation of to bother, it's ennuyer, d'accord? Déranger, we could agree on that. Cosmina Bellou went for m'embête. Oui, embêté would be a good option too. It's a bit more spoken, hein? So ennuyé would be a bit more formal, a bit more standard or correct. Let's have a look at the thing. So Kirill had ennuyé, so it's good. Hilary, well too. Bah écoutez, félicitations. Merci beaucoup pour cette participation. C'est très très gentil. Alors, because we want to study in a rational and efficient manner, we saw ce qui, and now we will go for ce que. D'accord? So let's have a look at this sentence. What I love. What I love. How could you translate what I love? Using, obviously, because this is the idea of the lesson, ce que. It's not the lesson, the exercise. Ce que. Go for it. Alors voilà, pas de problème, so everything seems to be extremely good. So ce que, as we started to put, so I don't know, Maurice Johnson, sorry, Maurice, we're just using French or English here, so I am sorry, I will have to click on you, I guess. Don't take it bad, but that's it. Merci, Maurice. Look, in that case, we will go for ce que, and then after that, we still need to put, we agree, the subject, je, d'accord? So whether you want to go for aimer, hein, I mean, I've been putting aimer, you could go for adorer if you want, no problem. So, but then remember, ce que, then you squeeze your subject, je, apostrophe in both cases, and after that your verb. Ce que j'aime, ce que j'adore. Très bien, look at the next one, one second, because apparently the machine doesn't want to change the page. What I admire. So what I admire, how could you say that in French? Allez-y. Alors, Kirill is asking a big question. What's the difference between qui and que? Well, in that case, this is what we call pronom relatif. I would definitely invite you to have a look at the video that I've been making, but if you look at it so far, ce qui, it's to replace the subject. So it means that basically you have ce qui, and then you have, after that, the verb. You don't have a subject because ce qui is the subject. Ce qui est beau, as we had. Hein? Ce qui is the subject, est is the verb. In that situation, ce que will replace what we call this grammatical object. So ce que, and look, in that situation, ce que j'admire, as you can see, we need to have the subject. Je is the subject. What I admire. I admire, sujet, verb, and after that, que, ce que, will be for the object. So in that situation, it will be ce que j'admire. Hein? Remember, admirer, regular verb from the first group, extremely simple to conjugate, so in that case, it should be with the e in the end. Ensuite, Alors, attendez. So, what you do is what you need to translate. Yossi is asking what the difference between adorer and admirer. Adorer, it's to adore, it's to love a lot, and then admirer, it's to admire. So it's slightly different. I don't know if in your language you've got the differences between the two, but in fact, for at least in French and I guess in English, it's slightly different. Let's agree if we don't go too far, you see, let's say that adorer, the first concept of adorer, but it's been changing a lot, but it was something that was related to religion. Adorer un dieu. Admirer, you can admire a person. But now it's not as clear as it used to be a long, long time ago. So in that situation, ce que tu fais. Alors, Samantha Alonso is asking ce que and not ce qui. I just explained that 1 minute ago. So you need to go back. So in that situation, ce que, and then we will put the subject. Tu, we agree, fait. If you want to go like Lisbeth for the vous form, totally possible, no problem. Ce que vous faites. It is really good. So ce que tu fais, ce que vous faites. So what we want, what we want, how could you translate that with this ce que structure? Allez-y. Alors, let's have a look at your things. So, of course, I would accept two things. The first one would be the classic translation of we want, and it would be nous voulons. Ce que nous voulons. Be careful, because I can see that I think it was Ashley or somebody else has been using this on. I would accept it. Remember that on. In that situation, you conjugate the verb in the third person, so it would be on veut, V-E-U-T. Ce qu'on veut. In some cases, we don't really use that because obviously this sound can be a bit rude and it's not really nice, but it's up to you after that. Ce que nous voulons, or then ce qu'on veut. Voilà, regardez le prochain. Let's have a look at the next one. So now it's getting a bit bigger. What you say interests me. What you say interests me. How would you structure that with this ce que structure that we have? Alors, Ashley saying, personne ne dit nous. Well, it depends where you are. It depends. Alors, let's have a look at the translation of this sentence. Ce que tu dis, so we agree that in that case, the verb dire should be conjugated in the second form. So it's tu dis, D-I-S. And then the verb is intéressé, d'accord? And of course, you will put the pronoun before me. You drop the, you put the apostrophe. Ce que tu dis m'intéresse. Ce que tu dis m'intéresse would be the proper translation for that. And it seems that everything is okay for you. Remember, if you go for ce que vous, in that situation, it should be dites, hein, D-I-T-E-S. It's a tricky verb. Hein. Je dis, I-S, tu dis, I-S. Il dit, I-T. Nous disons, vous dites, D-I-T-E-S, ils, elles disent. Très bien. Valéa Torres, I'm sorry, but we only speak French or English here. Merci beaucoup, Valé. Allez, let's have a look at the next one. What you say makes me sad. What you say makes me sad. Allez-y. Alors, Ashley, si j'avais un entretien sur place, je vais dire tout. No, but it depends, Ashley. You know, keep in mind that if it's extremely formal and really it's an advice, huh? If it's extremely formal and you are interacting with person of what we could call a certain age, I would advise you to go for nous first and then listen to the way people will use. It's really according to the places where you go and the persons that you are interacting with. So go for nous first instead of going for on, because trust me, there is a generation that considers that on was not proper at all and well, at different type of levels. And I mean, you get my point. Ce que tu dis me rend triste. So in that situation, well, we could go for attristé. Yeah, I can see that MJ is going for attristé. So I wanted to quiz you and to see you if you wanted to reuse attristé that we saw. Or then if you want to use rendre triste, which is the other option. Remember, attristé, as MJ has been writing that, and it's really, really good. Merci beaucoup, MJ. So, ce que tu dis me rend triste. Ce que tu dis m'attriste. Hein, the verb that we saw a few minutes ago. Allez, on continue. What you say makes me laugh. What you say makes me laugh. Allez-y. Alors, let's have a look, and it seems that everything is okay, because basically we reuse the same structure that we've been using several times already. Ce que tu dis, d'accord, me fait rire. Alors, if you want to go for amuser, well, I could, because Kirill wanted to use amuser. Remember, it should be m'amuse, hein, in that case, M apostrophe, and then amuse. Hein. Ce que tu dis m'amuse could be an option, but amuser, it's not really to laugh. In that case, it's really the ha ha ha, me fait rire. Hein. Ce que tu dis me fait rire. Allez, let's have a look at the next one. What you say worries me. What you say worries me. Same structure with the ce que, and make the sentence. Allez-y. Yeah, Ashley, and this is always my advice to people. It's better to look too polite than the opposite, because you can always go back from the too polite to something that is less polite. When you start, you see my point. It's difficult to change the image that people will have of you. Thank you. Alors, so far so good, félicitations, it's exactly the same structure that we've been having since the beginning, ce que tu dis, hein, ce que tu dis, same thing here, D-D-E-S. In that situation, we'll use this verb inquiéter, inquiéter, so after that you, you put the pronoun, hein, so it's pronom complément d'objet direct, apostrophe, of course, because your verb is starting with the vowel or sound of a vowel. Ce que tu dis m'inquiète. Lanora wanted to go for préoccupé. It could be a good option too. Ouais. Ce que tu dis me préoccupe. Hein. It would be totally correct, Lanora. Merci beaucoup en tout cas. Allez, let's have a look at the next one. What you do is your business. What you do is your business. Allez, same thing, ce que, hein, and then you structure your sentence. Merci. Alors, je regarde vos petites choses. Regardez. Personally, I would go for this structure. Ce que tu fais te regarde. Remember that regarder can be used like that. Ça me regarde, it's my business. Ça te regarde, it's your business. So remember that the verb regarder can be definitely used in this situation. So, ce que tu fais te regarde. Ce qu'il fait le regarde. Ce qu'elle fait la regarde. Try to play with this structure because this is really the structure that we would use in most of the cases to express this this concept. After that, you went for ce que tu fais, c'est tes affaires. Yeah, but it's not really, it's spoken, it could be extremely informal. I was offering you the proper way to make it short and to make it quite clear, and especially to introduce this, probably for you, maybe, a new way to conceive the meaning of regarder, d'accord? So regarder, it's not only to watch, hein, but it's also like this concept of it concerns you, it's your business, it's my business, c'est, ça me regarde, ça te regarde. Qu'est-ce qu'elle dit Victoria Jacques? This is my brain on French aujourd'hui. It's bubbling everywhere. Okay, look at the time. That's the time for today. Merci beaucoup. Remember that tomorrow we'll have intermediate, so we'll continue, this series of exercises like that. And then after that, it will be advanced. Advanced will be on Saturday, and it will be only in French. Merci beaucoup. Au revoir. Et à demain. See you tomorrow if you're there. Merci. Seistyksin yksin parvekkeen kaiteella. Alla maailma, jonne et tahdo palata. Suurin ongelma on, ettei ole ongelmaa. Tarpeeksi soha, joka allen sinut musertaa. Sen reunan ja asetut roikkumaan niin. Et ainoa mitä tehdä pitää, on pitää kiinni. Vai kikkunasta tippumaan. Vai
sitä ymmärrä, kuinka me turhaan pelätään. Mulla on ratkaisu, en koita ratkaista mitään. Hengitä ulos ja hengitä uudestaan sisään. Men yli sen reunan ja asetut roikkumaan niin. Ainoa mitä tehdä pitää, on pitää kiinni.